Samsung rolled out a big update to the Galaxy S21 series a few days back. I got this update of about 1 GB and at first, I wondered how come a regular update is so big. It turns out this was an update carrying some improvements along with some new features. So as you can see, this update brings a security patch of August 1 and I got this update on September 4th. This update, if you have already heard of it, is being called the One USB 1.1, but inside the phone's software section, it's still called the One UI 3.1. Anyways, let me tell you what's new in this latest software update for the Galaxy S21 and the A series. First of all, Samsung has improved the animations. I can't tell you how much difference is there, but this is what the animations look like now. The phone seems a bit smoother, the applications open up and close faster than before. The camera turns up faster, switching the camera between the front camera and the rear camera is a bit fast. I am also noticing a slightly better battery output from my S21 Ultra since the day this update has arrived. And another thing that I noticed, I believe that the heat dissipation from my phone is much better. My phone doesn't get as hot as it used to get back in the day. If you look into the toggles area of your phone, inside the new toggles, you will find two new features. The first one is the bedtime. Bedtime was a part of the digital well-being. Samsung just made its toggle available now. It turns on the Do Not Disturb feature and turns the screen gray. You can either schedule it or the bedtime stays on until you yourself turn it off. There is bedtime integration in the clock app with the alarm too. The second feature is the processing speed. This was previously called enhanced processing, so Samsung kind of renamed this feature and its options. You can find the optimized, high and maximum in the processing speed. Choose one of these according to your own choice. And if you are someone like me, you are probably not going to care about the processing speed in your phone. Some other changes include the new accent colors under some applications. Inside the clock application, you can find the weather icon next to the name of the countries now, and if you click on the weather icon, it takes you to the weather details of that particular country. The weather app has got a new help feature which shows you how you can add a new weather widget and how to use the whole weather app. This update has already rolled out to the Galaxy A52 and the A72 users. If you are interested in seeing a dedicated video on those two devices, do tell me in the comment section down below. Subscribe if you haven't yet and hit that like button too. Our like target for this video is 1000 likes. With that being said, I will sign off and see you all in the next one.